Good morning, Rams, and welcome back to another remote edition of the Ram Report Morning Show. I'm Tyler Schamper, and as always, we continue to bring you the best news that Hightstown has to offer. The wave of protests that have swept the nation in the aftermath of the killing of George Floyd has had an impact right here in Hightstown, with HHS students leading the way. Our correspondent, Brandon Sagbo, was there as Hightstown Rams took to the streets.
I can't breathe. These three words have swept the nation and caused a huge influence on society, politics, and social media. Last Monday, the nation watched as Officer Derek Chauvin of the Minneapolis Police Department put his knee on the neck of George Floyd, choking and killing him. Many students took to social media to spread awareness and educate others on the Black Lives Matter movement. But a few students went even further and organized a whole protest in downtown Hightstown. Hundreds of people joined the protest, from students to alumni to teachers and administrators. Dressed in all black, the Hightstown community walked down Main Street, expressing their fear, expressing their anger, and demanding justice, not just for George Floyd, but for every black life that was taken at the hand of the police. Hightstown and East Windsor police barricaded the rest of Main Street to guide the march back towards the school. However, the protest wasn't going anywhere unless they knew the police were on their side. All the protesters took a knee and asked for the officers to do the same in show of support.
Ridiculous! I'm no different from him! I'm no different from her! I'm no different from her! We want you! This is not hate! This is all love! I just want you to love me back! That's all I want!
After 20 minutes of pleading, the officers finally took a knee in solidarity. Though the Black Lives Matter movement has the support of the law enforcement in our community, does not mean the fight is over.
We really the next generation for real. I'm like the students of today, we're the adults of tomorrow. So as long as all of us know what's up, everyone here today knows what's up. And as long as we maintain that mindset throughout our life, in the future we'll be good. That's it.
What I wanted to accomplish here today was just equality. I just want peace, love, and understanding from everyone. And that's all we can ask for and all it takes. This crowd today was beautiful, man. That's art. This is Hightstown right here.
It is absolutely great to see Hightstown students coming out here peacefully and using their rights to demand change. For the Ram Report, I'm Brandon Sagbo. Back to you.
Thanks, Brandon. I loved seeing the community come together in the fight for justice. Now, graduation has been a bit confusing this year with all the guidelines and restrictions in the midst of this pandemic. So we sent Ram reporter Emily Dougherty to clear up the air.
In light of the recent announcement from Governor Murphy, Hightstown has begun to plan a summer outdoor graduation ceremony to honor our graduates. However, current guidelines only allow for 25 people. The administration is awaiting further guidelines from the state to ensure that everyone stays safe. In the meantime, we are still proceeding with our individual photo and video events, the distribution of official diplomas, June 16th and 17th, and our virtual graduation ceremony on June 18th. During the individual event, students will be required to wear a mask, and they can bring up to 4 family members with them. A video will be taken of each student walking across the stage to pick up their diploma case. Each student will be given 5 minutes to complete this process. Congratulations to all our graduating seniors. I'm Emily Dougherty, reporting for the Ram Report. Back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Emily. I'm glad that I can still get a chance to walk on stage and get my pictures taken. Next up, we have Spencer Cohen giving us a preview of this summer and if jobs will even be open.
Every summer, high school students in Hightstown and across the country seek summer jobs to make some extra money for themselves and for their families. However, with the coronavirus still present in New Jersey, many businesses that would normally attract high school workers remain closed. These include pools, amusement parks, and sleepaway summer camps.
I was supposed to work at a 7-week sleepaway camp this summer called Camp Blue Ridge in Pennsylvania, but sadly they canceled, so now I have to figure out what to do with myself all summer. I might get a job over here, get a job down the shore, I'm not sure yet, but it's definitely going to be a change from my normal summers at camp.
With businesses recently reopening and continuing operations through curbside pickup. Other students have been working during remote learning and plan to continue with their same job over the summer.
I'm a waiter at the Mill Lakes Retirement Home. Some new guidelines that I have to follow to ensure the safety of others as well as myself is I have to take my temperature every single time I walk into the facility. I have to wear a mask at all times. Instead of a full dining service like we usually do, we have to deliver residents' meals to their apartments.
With summer just around the corner, it will be interesting to see how Hightstown students will adapt to these unprecedented times. I'm Spencer Cohen for the Ram Report. Back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Spence. Now, to close off today's episode, we have a special segment. Into the Woods, this year's school musical, was set to premiere the week after we left school. But thanks to the cast and crew, we can give you a little taste of what it might have been like. Here's Mr. Camps.
Hello, Hightstown. Mr. Camps here. As most of you know, the HHS Drama Club was not able to bring its spring musical, Into the Woods, to performance. I just want to take a moment to thank all those who made this show possible. From the actors, to the musicians, to the set, lighting, sound, prop, and costume crews, we celebrate you. Thank you for not just your talents, but your professionalism and positive attitude throughout this entire process. And to the senior members of Drama Club, I just want to thank you for modeling resiliency and camaraderie. We recognize you and your leadership, and we're sorry we weren't able to give you a proper performance. We hope this helps. So in honor of the class of 2020 and the entire cast, crews, and musicians, we'd like to share with you all a few moments in the woods. Enjoy.
Careful the things you say, children will listen. Careful the things you do, children will see and learn. Children may not obey, but children will listen. Children will look to you for which way to turn. To learn what to be, careful before you say, listen to me. Children will listen. Careful the wish you make, wishes our children. Careful the path they take, wishes come true. Not free.
Into the woods each time you go, there's more to learn of what you to go. Into the woods, but not too slow. Into the woods, it's nearing midnight. Into the woods to find the wolf, to heed the witch, to honor the giant, to mind, to heed, to find, to think, to teach the giant, to go to the festival. Into the woods, into the woods, into the woods, and out of the woods, and happy ever after.
I wish.
Wow. That was just amazing. Be sure to check out the very last RAM report of the school year coming up next week. Until then, I'm your host, Tyler Schamper, and have a RAM-tastic day.